Something very weird happened. My wife received a call from an unknown number.
Hello? Hello? Hello?
The weird part was, no one seemed to be speaking on the other side.
Hello?
Initially, like everyone, she thought it was a network issue. But what I found out was, this was not a network issue. This was actually a part of a deepfake scam running all over the country. Number of deepfake incidents in India have almost tripled. From a 73-year-old man in Kerala losing 40,000 rupees to a fake WhatsApp call, to a company involved with the construction of Statue of Unity losing $25 million. No one is spared from a deepfake scam. So, will you be affected? Well, it's not a question of if, it's actually a question of when. In this video, we'll show you how a deepfake video works.
This looks very real.
Why you should never pick up unknown calls. How easy it is for someone to clone not just your voice.
What?
It's all this.
But also video of your loved ones. And finally, what you can do to protect yourself. This is not some made-up scenario. On 24th October 2023, a 68-year-old man named Harish Chand Chawla receives a call from an unknown number.
Hello?
Hello?
Neha? Is that you?
Thank God you recognized me.
Neha was Harish Chawla's niece, also called Bhatiji in Hindi.
I'm in a big problem, Baba. Police have taken me into custody. Please help, Baba.
Hey, hello. Your Bhatiji's bank account was used by someone in cyber fraud. Right now, we have taken her in our custody. If you want us to release her, transfer 70,000 rupees immediately. You'll receive our account details over WhatsApp. Hurry.
Harish Chawla immediately transfers 70,000 rupees to the account number. Harish was scammed. His bhatiji's voice was actually cloned and used against him to commit a cyber fraud and basically rob him out of his hard-earned money. Now think for a moment. If it is so easy to scam individual people out of their hard-earned money, imagine the scale of cyber fraud that is running by cloning voices of powerful politicians or powerful business people. This is a clip of our finance minister.
Our experts have just rolled out a brand new artificial intelligence system that helps you earn 3 to 4 times more profit every single day than before. This means your initial 25,000 rupees can now generate over 90,000 rupees daily. That's roughly 25 lakh every month.
Scamsters were able to create a deep fake video of a finance minister promote a fraud app. In this next deepfake video, Sudha Murthy is seen promoting some other fake fraud app. At this point, you may think only older people or people that are less tech savvy would be fooled by all these deepfake scams. But think again. Arup Industries is a multinational British company. In its Hong Kong office, an employee was sitting in a conference room in a Zoom call with senior leadership, including CFO and other senior colleagues. CFO asked the employee to make certain bank transfers. Although the employee felt something was off, CFO himself was live on the Zoom call, authorizing him to make those transfers. The employee was convinced by this visual evidence and as a result, he transferred $25 million to 5 different bank accounts. A week later, it was discovered every single participant on that Zoom call, other than the employee sitting in the office, was actually a deep fake. Scamsters used publicly available videos of Arup's CFO and other senior leadership to construct a very realistic deepfake video. In this case, the deepfake video was not even a pre-recorded video. Rather, it was a live feed from the scammer's computer. A more sophisticated way to create a deepfake. So, can I create a deepfake video of someone? Well, to answer this, I need to understand more about how these deepfake technology actually works. In 1994, a movie called Forrest Gump was released. In one of the famous scenes of the movie, Tom Hanks goes on to shake hands with John F. Kennedy, one of the former US president.
Congratulations. How does it feel to be an All-American?
Very good, sir.
Congratulations. How do you feel?
I gotta pee.
I believe he said he had to go pee.
The only problem was, John F. Kennedy had already been assassinated in 1963. Therefore, the Tom Hanks of 1994 could not have shaken hands with Kennedy. Now, the audio part of this scene was easy. Director simply asked a skilled voice artist to speak like John F. Kennedy. But the difficult part was the video. The VFX team of Forrest Gump had to look at thousands of hours worth of White House archival footage. Then, after finding an actual footage of Kennedy, they had to track this footage frame by frame. The VFX team even superimposed lip movements from the archival footage onto the Kennedy footage that you see in the film, so that mouth movements match what he is saying on the screen. In fact, tell me if you can spot something weird in this video.
Congratulations. How does it feel to be an All-American?
Very good, sir.
Congratulations. How do you feel?
I gotta pee.
I believe he said he had to go pee.
Yes, the tie color changes in between the scene. This is because there are two different videos of actual John F. Kennedy staged together. In 1994, this required an army of VFX editors and millions of dollars. This was pure human skill, artistic skill. There was no machine learning happening here. Therefore, unsurprisingly, Forrest Gump also won an Academy Award for the best visual effects. Just 3 years later, in 1997, three researchers were working on a project called Video Rewrite. Here, they demonstrated the first ever system which was capable of reanimating the lip movement according to the audio that was fed into it. In other words, they could make anyone say anything. And to demonstrate that, they chose a brilliant example. They took John F. Kennedy's archival footage and made him speak words which he had never ever spoken before. This is the actual video of Kennedy.
I call upon Chairman Khrushchev.
This was modified to
I never met Forrest Gump.
I never met Forrest Gump. Or
I did not inhale.
Or
read my lips.
Or
Video Rewrite gives lip-synced movies.
Now, the way this was done was remarkably similar to how Forrest Gump VFX team was able to stitch a version of John F. Kennedy into the Forrest Gump movie scene. To do this, they took hundreds of hours worth of John F. Kennedy speeches. Then, a computer program extracts the moving lips out of these videos. Then, this computer program tries to map each lip movement to a sound. For example, the word parrot. The word parrot can be broken down into two sounds, pa and rut. So for the sounds pa, the mouth makes a round O shape, pa. And for the sound rut, the mouth makes slightly smaller O shape, pa, rut, pa, rut. In the case of John F. Kennedy, the computer algorithm creates a mapping. How do the lips look when the sound pa is spoken? And then how do the lips look when the sound rut is spoken? By combining these two, Kennedy can speak the word parrot even if he had never spoken this word before. Now, if you think, how is this even possible? You can have unlimited sounds, which means you can have unlimited lip movements for those sounds. But interestingly, that is not the case. Look carefully. Pa, ba, ma. These are all spoken with closed lips. And then fa, va, these are spoken with teeth on the lip. You can pause the video and try this yourself. Both a and a are spoken with open mouth. Then sounds like ta, da, sa, za are spoken with tongue behind the teeth. The point here being, a lot of these sounds can actually collapse into one visual shape. Now let's take the example of I never met Forrest Gump. This can be separated into individual sounds like this. I never met Forrest Gump. The machine learning algorithm will find frames of lips which correspond to these individual sounds. Then these images of lips will be pasted on the video provided.
I never met Forrest Gump.
Now this works brilliantly because all the details about the original video are preserved. The eyes are the same, the nose is the same, the ears are the same, the body is the same, even the lips, if you think about it, even the lips that are modified, even those lips are actually real images, real frames of John F. Kennedy in this case. These images are not artificially generated by the computer. Those lips actually belong to Kennedy. They are just taken from different archived videos. From 1997, we have come a long way. In today's generation and age, high definition videos of celebrities, politicians, business people, they are easily available online. And as more data goes into these models, higher is the quality of deepfake videos that we can get from them. This is a video of Barack Obama.
President Trump is a total and complete dipshit. Now, you see, I would never say these things, at least not in a public address, but someone else would. Someone like Jordan Peele. This is a dangerous time.
Look at how terrifyingly real it is. Now, this video was made with consent from Obama. He wanted to spread awareness on what this technology is capable of. But think for a moment on how it can be misused. Just before Lok Sabha elections, deepfakes of Aamir Khan and Ranveer Singh were circulated on WhatsApp. Now, it does not matter whether these deepfakes were supporting a particular party or were they bashing some other particular party. What matters is these were being used to manipulate voters, manipulate common public just before the election. Now, here's the thing. It's very easy to assume these deepfakes were circulated by the political parties themselves who are rivals. But the bigger problem is, what if foreign entities start circulating deepfakes to manipulate elections in their favor? Technology, or rather misuse of technology, cannot be limited by the boundaries of a country. In 2024, FBI found out Russia was circulating deepfake videos on how election fraud was happening all over the US.
The FBI with a rare warning today that videos like these,
three linked groups have been apprehended for rigging early voting,
are fake videos and meant to interfere with the election.
It also found out Iranian groups were circulating deepfake videos on the internet. The intention was very simple: create distrust in the American voting system in the eyes of an average American. So you remember the blank call that you got in the starting? So how dangerous do you think that blank call was?
I mean, it's just a blank call, so it seems harmless. You can call the person from the other end again, so...
It seems like a network issue, right?
Yeah, it seems like a network issue.
So this is what I did. I took your voice samples, that hello, hello that you said, and then I mixed it with one image that I had of you. And then using just open source tools, which means just free of cost, I was able to create this. Have a look. So here is what I did. Step 1, I took one still image of my wife. Step 2, I recorded this video of myself. Hello. My husband is always right. Step 3, now I fed both of them into WAN 2.2 open source model. This animated the still image using hand movements from my original video. Hello. My husband is always right. Step 4. Took my wife's voice samples.
Hello? Hello? Hello?
And the audio of my recorded voice, fed them into text-to-speech models to convert my voice to my wife's. End result is this.
Hello? My husband is always right.
What?
Exactly right. So now answer me this question. Now this seems funny at first, but if I send this video to a distant relative of yours, let's say who is 70 years of age, Do you think they'll be able to tell the difference if this is fake?
I don't think so.
So the kind of deepfake video that I was able to produce with just one video of yours, like, this is the fact that has blown me. And, you know, I can push it even a level up. So what I can do is, instead of doing a pre-recorded video for you, I can create a live deepfake video. So what I'll do is, you'll basically receive a call. The call will be from my number, but as soon as you'll pick up the call, you won't see my face on it. You will see someone else's face on it. The video on the right is the original video, and the video on the left is the deepfake video. This is the video that is visible to the other caller. So, it's crazy, right? The video is a bit laggy, more on that later, but the point is, I can put on anyone's face.
This looks very real. Very, very real.
Yeah. Here's the thing, I know the video is a bit laggy and low resolution, but that can be easily fixed by a powerful system. And I know that you may not be fully convinced by me being Shah Rukh Khan, but think for a moment. If someone calls your grandmother with your face, will she be able to tell the difference? So, the question is, do you think we should ban this deepfake technology? A technology like this can be used as a tool for warfare, as a tool for creating distrust, interfering with elections, and obviously financial scams. But at the same time, like everything, it is just a tool. For example, YouTube is experimenting with this technology to not just dub videos in many languages, but also to create lip movements to sync with those dubbed languages. This ensures YouTube videos appear natural in almost all the languages that are present. This same technology was used to create Mahabharat, Ek Dharma Yudh TV show, which enables these stories of India to reach a far wider audience. Then UK health agency used deepfake versions of David Beckham to spread anti-malaria messages in 9 different languages. Think about the lives saved. Politicians are using it to live translate their speeches into different regional languages, enabling a greater participation in democracy, something that is much needed today. One thing you need to understand is, you cannot completely depend on laws and regulations to save you from the bad effects of this technology. As with any other technology, regulations will always play a catch-up with the latest technology. So if you get a call from someone, whether you know them, you don't know them, be extra vigilant. Are they saying something that they would never say? Be extra vigilant. Does their audio or video appear out of sync? Be extra vigilant. Are they requesting large sums of money? Again, be extra vigilant. Can you call them back and verify the request? This is how you can safeguard yourselves and others in the face of deepfake videos. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, you can check out our beautifully produced videos on our channel. Let's meet in the next video. Thank you.